Praise the Lord, as I headed back working from home today, and thought I would drop a nugget in your spirit and your soul if I can. You know, this won't take long. You know, oftentimes, the best way to make a comeback, or the best way to make things better for yourself and someone else, is to absolutely change. You can change your clothes, you can change your mind, you can change your job, you can change where you live, but the greatest change in the world is your heart and mind change, which makes things better for your relationship, your marriage, others. You know, and so many people refuse to change. If you don't like it, you can leave. Take your stuff and get out. Go find somebody that fits you and all that mess. And that's just so childish. And if a man or a woman, a husband or a wife, boyfriend or girlfriend, fiance, partner or partner is telling you, hey, you're hurting me, your behavior, your conduct, and your response is, but go find somebody that you like, but go find somebody the way you want them to be. No. If something is hurting or bothering someone, and it's non-conducive, and it's reducing your marriage, your morality, your mentality, your emotional state, your spiritual state, you ought to change. If you love that person, change. Don't tell them, take your stuff and leave. But I can find somebody else. Plenty of men or plenty of women want me. You know, and just change and stop making excuses for your horrible behavior. And also, don't you make excuses for someone else's horrible behavior. Just change, man. You know, change your clothes, change the location, change your job, change your heart and mind, change your lifestyle, change. I've changed, I'm changing, and I'm looking for further change within myself. So you can take your stuff and leave. Go find somebody that fits your bill. You know, you knew I was like this when you met me. I had someone tell me that one time. I said, okay, well, I said, watch this. I suppose I used to kick your butt. And one day you come and say, stop beating me, please. And I say to you, you knew I was like this when you met me. Pow! Nope. Wrong words, wrong way. It's selfish not to seek change. It's selfish to tell somebody if you don't like it, leave it. Well, they gonna leave you because they don't like it. It's just a matter of time as I leave this alone. So change. That's the best apology in life. The best lo sienta. The best protodone. The best I'm sorry, the best please forgive me, is to change. That's the best thing in life. You know, everything changed. The TV has changed. The telephone has changed. Technology has changed a lot of things. The airliner, the jet, the tank, the luxury ship, you know, the cruise ship. The air conditioner, the walkie-talkie, the radio. Everything has changed. But man and woman seem to have a problem with change. Technology don't fit us. Change does. So the best apology in life is to seek that significant change whereby it makes you, your life, your marriage, your friendship better. Peace. Change. It won't hurt you. One.